Dear students, welcome to the next lecture in this video series. We are discussing differential amplifiers. This presentation is created and narrated by Hemant Satpute, teacher, Department of Electronics Science, Fergusson College, Junior Wing, Pune 4. We are discussing differential amplifiers. So, in this lecture, we will learn about different types of differential amplifiers. There are four types of differential amplifier configurations. Number one, dual input, balanced output. That means dual input, dual output. Second one, dual input, unbalanced output or single output. The single input, balanced output. And single input, unbalanced output. So these are four configurations. Let's take a quick look over each one of them. These configurations are defined according to the number of input signals used and the way output measured. When we use two inputs, the configuration is said to be dual input. Otherwise, it is single input. If the output is measured between two collectors, the configuration is referred to as balanced output. On the other hand, if output is measured at either collector with respect to ground, the configuration is said to be unbalanced output. For proper operation of differential amplifier, a transistor array and matched components must be used. The following circuits shows differential circuit configurations. First one, dual input, balanced output. So, if you refer to this particular diagram, two inputs, dual, Vin1 and Vin2, Vin1 and Vin2 are applied to the bases B1 and B2 of transistors Q1 and Q2. The output Vout is measured between two collectors C1 and C2. Again, all the components are matched. That means both RCs are identical, both transistors are identical, both Rin1 and Rin2, they are also identical. Next configuration is dual input, unbalanced output. So, two input signals are used, Vin1 and Vin2. The Q1 output is measured at only one of the two collectors with respect to ground. So, output is measured at one of the collectors with respect to ground. So, two inputs are present, that's why dual input, and output is taken from one of the collectors, that's why unbalanced output. Again, all components are perfectly matched. Both RCs, both Rin and both transistors, they are perfectly matched. So, this is dual input, unbalanced output configuration. Next one is single input, balanced output. As the circuit diagram shows, single input is applied to the base of transistor Q1, Vin1 or Vin is this only input. And the output is measured between the two collectors. This output is measured between the two collectors. So, the output is said to be balanced. So, single input and balanced output. Again, all the components are perfectly matched. Both RCs, both transistors, they are perfectly matched. So, this is single input but balanced output configuration. Now, next one is single input, unbalanced output. As the diagram shows, an input signal is applied to the base of either of the transistors and output is measured at either of the collectors. That is, input is applied to the base of transistor Q1 here as shown in the diagram and the output is measured at the collector of transistor Q2. So, single input, single output. So, single input, unbalanced output. Again, all the components are perfectly matched. Both resistors RC, transistors Q1 and Q2, they are perfectly matched. So, this is the configuration single input, unbalanced output of differential amplifier. That's all for today's lecture. Stay tuned for the next lecture in the series. Please do visit our YouTube video channel, FYJC Vocational Electronics, for all the video lectures in this series. Subscribe, like, share, and stay tuned.